Funnel charts are a new chart type to Excel. Previously, in other versions, you could create this kind of effect, but you had to do it by creating stacked column charts and pyramid charts and other convoluted methods to get there. My name is Jason Morrell, and I'm going to show you how to produce one of these funnel charts. So here I've got two examples. The first example shows Australian population data from the biggest state down to the smallest state. As you can see, the funnel kind of goes from the biggest amounts down to the smallest amounts in what looks like a funnel, hence its name. Now, what you've got to be careful of before you create the chart is to make sure your data is sorted in descending order. The second example down here is a job application process. So for this particular job, there were 550 applicants, 50 were shortlisted, 32 were interviewed, 10 made it through to the second interview, and 2 were hired. So the funnel chart here shows you the way those figures reduce from the initial applications down to the hire. Now, if the data wasn't sorted in descending order, let's say I resorted the states into alphabetical order, you can see that the funnel is all over the place. And that's why you need the numbers in descending order, because that's what forms the natural flow of the funnel. I'm going to delete the chart that I already have, and I'm going to recreate it. So firstly, let's resort the list into descending population order. So biggest number at the top, smallest number at the bottom. Select anywhere in the table, go to your Insert tab, find the Waterfall and Stock Chart category, and in there, there's a chart type called Funnel. You can also find this if you go to Recommended Charts and the All Charts tab. You'll find Funnel down towards the bottom. Whichever way you get there is fine. When you choose it, it gives you the initial funnel chart. So let's just move that so you can see it clearly. So we might want to change the font color here because it's kind of dark on dark. If I click any one of those numbers, I can then go to the Home tab and choose maybe the font color, make it white, and that way you can see the text a lot more clearly. You'll notice the bottom three elements of this funnel, there's not enough room to show the data, so it just doesn't display it. If your data shows a bit of a wider funnel so that all the way down you've got more width to play with, what you may want to do is to actually put the state name in this case next to the number on the funnel. So to do that, all you've got to do is to click the plus sign and go to your data labels. And if you go to more data label options here, on the side panel, it'll show you your data label options. And you can then tick category name and it will add the state name next to the state figure. By doing that, you can see that the bottom five now don't have room to display the state name as well. So in this case, that's a bad example to do it on. But if your data allows it, you might want to do that. If you're going to do this and put the state name on the funnel data, you might want to also remove it from the labels over here. So again, click the plus sign here and just turn off the axes, and that will just show the funnel with no other labeling on it. If you want to increase the gap between each element on the funnel, let's just close that for a second. What you can do is to double click any one of these funnel elements, and it brings you into the series options here, and it says gap width. It's currently set to 6%. If you nudge that up or increase the figure there, you'll see the gap between the elements changing. So if we maybe just make that 50%, a nice big gap, you can see the effect that's had. So funnel charts are very easy to work with. Get some data together and give one a go.